हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। आज हम बात करेंगे अबाउट द 10 इंटरेस्टिंग कार्स दैट श्रीलंका गेट्स बट इंडिया डजंट। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द वीडियो। नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द फर्स्ट कार दैट इज ऑल न्यू स्विफ्ट that was launched earlier this year. As you know, the Indian Swift comes with 1.2 liter petrol engine and 1.3 liter diesel engine. Now talking about the Sri Lankan market, it gets a 1.2 liter hybrid Swift that also has a 4-wheel drive option. It looks quite similar to the regular Swift, but it comes with a sportier grille. The car is named as Swift Hybrid RS and it is powered by a 1.2 liter petrol engine that produces a maximum of 89 bhp, and it can give maximum of 27 km per liter mileage. Now talking about the second car, that is Wagoner, which is extremely popular in the Indian market. In Sri Lanka, Suzuki offers the all-new Wagoner Hybrid, which is powered by the 660cc 3-cylinder petrol engine that develops a maximum of 51 bhp of power and 60 Nm of torque. It only gets a CVT transmission and it claims a fuel efficiency of 33 km per liter. Going on to the next car, that is Honda HR-V. While the WR-V has become extremely popular in the Indian market, the Sri Lankan market gets the Honda HR-V compact SUV, which is powered by a 1.5 liter petrol engine and it develops around 118 bhp of power and 145 Nm of torque. It gets the torque converter automatic transmission with a lock-up clutch, as there is no manual transmission available with this car. Next one is Nissan Patrol, which offers both Y61 and Y62 SUVs in the Sri Lankan market. While the Y61 is the legendary vehicle, it is replaced by the Y62 version, which is a newer version. The car is available in two versions powered by the same engine block in the Sri Lankan market. Both the version gets a 5.5 liter V8 engine block, which one gets direct fuel injection and produces a power of 397 bhp and a torque of 560 Nm. The other version gets an MPFI system that produces a maximum of 319 bhp of power and 526 Nm of torque. The higher powered engine gets a 7-speed automatic transmission, while the other one gets a 5-speed transmission. Now next one is Nissan Navara, which is a full-size pickup truck that belongs to the segment of Toyota Fortuner and the Ford Endeavour. The 7-seater SUV is available in the Sri Lankan market, which is quite popular there, and it gets powered by a 2.5 liter 4-cylinder petrol engine with an automatic transmission. Now coming to the next, that is Hyundai Ioniq, which is showcased in the Auto Expo 2018 Delhi earlier this year. And talking about this, the Sri Lankan market already gets this model in the hybrid form. The fully hybrid version of this car is powered by a 1.6 liter GDI petrol engine, which gets a maximum of 102 bhp of power and 147 Nm of torque. The petrol engine is also supported by an electric motor that adds a 42.4 bhp of power and 169.4 Nm of torque. Next is Toyota Rush, which is another compact SUV that is available in the Sri Lankan market, and it competes with the likes of Mahindra XUV500. The 7-seater SUV is available with both petrol and diesel engine in the Sri Lankan market. It gets a 1.5-liter petrol engine that develops a power of 107 bhp and maximum torque of 141 Nm. There is also a diesel engine option which generates a maximum of 100 bhp of power and a torque of 220 Nm. Next is Toyota RAV4, which is quite popular SUV in many international markets. It takes on the likes of Honda CR-V, and it is powered by a 2.5-liter petrol engine in the Sri Lankan market, and also gets a hybrid option. The 2.5-liter engine generates a maximum power of 176 bhp and a torque of 233 Nm. The hybrid version offers 194 bhp of power and 279 Nm of torque. Both the engine options are only available with an automatic transmission, and there is no all-wheel drive system available with this car. Now, next one is Toyota Avanza, which is a smaller sibling of Toyota Innova Crysta. Avanza competes with the likes of Suzuki Ertiga and looks quite similar to the Toyota Innova Crysta. It is powered by a 1.5-liter petrol engine that generates a maximum power of 103 bhp and torque of 136 Nm. There is also a smaller engine that is 1.3-liter that generates a maximum power of 95 bhp and 121 Nm of torque. Now coming to the last one, but not the least, that is Toyota Hilux. The Toyota Hilux is an extremely popular vehicle in the international markets. It is based on the same platform as the Toyota Fortuner, but because of the low popularity of the pickup trucks in the Indian market, the car never made it to India. The pickup truck that is quite capable is powered by a range of petrol and diesel engine options. The petrol engine ranges from 2-liter to 4-liter, while the diesel engine option ranges from 2.4-liter to 3-liter options. Toyota's official website in Sri Lanka does not mention the engine options that is available in the domestic market. So that's all about 10 interesting cars. I hope you like my video. If you like the video, press the thumbs up button below, share it with your friends, and also subscribe to my channel for more videos like this.